Hello and welcome to this week's Rocksmith DevStream. I'm Doug Lilly. I'm your comm dev and host for tonight's festivities. It's a bit of a Halloween-ish themed episode we've got today. We've got four songs from the band Ghost coming up and some note trackers to play them. Coming up soon, we're going to see a trailer for this song, the song pack. So if you're not sure what the big fuss is about Ghost, you've never listened to them, now's a good time to see what all the hubbub is about. After that, we're going to have a brief pre-recorded session with a guest that we had earlier this week, and then we'll be back live, and we'll be back to the present. It'll be nice. Take a look at Ghost. I can feel the thunder. And welcome back to this week's Rocksmith live stream. Once again, I am your host and Rocksmith comdev, Doug Lilly, coming at you from the past, from several days in the beyond. This week, Four songs from the band Ghost, or Ghost BC, depending on where you were when they came out with what. We'll just call them Ghost. It's probably fine. I like it. Coming up right now, who do we have here? None other than Greg Studley and Elliot Rudner. Hello, guys.
Hey, what's
Hello.
Going on?
Hello.
Hello. Greg, obviously, note tracker for Ritual.
Mm-hmm.
Elliot joining us from the great northern beyond of Canada.
Canada.
Canada. You're visiting. Why are you here?
I was there for TwitchCon in San Jose. Mm-hmm. So my flight is a bit. One of the. Got to catch the red eye. So.
Yeah. Yeah. so we'll be flying all night. Yeah. So TwitchCon was in San Jose, just about an hour south of San Francisco, which is where we're coming at you from. And you want to do some Ghost with us?
Yeah.
Right?
I saw Ghost open for Mastodon, and that was this era.
I saw
of
that tour.
Opus Eponymous. And this song really stuck out to me, so I'm pretty excited that you put it in, so thanks.
Oh, yeah, of course. You're welcome. You're welcome. Well, let's give some thanks to Greg Studley, because you note-tracked it.
Yes.
Yeah. Do you have any insights?
Insights? Yeah. You know what? I was not very familiar, but after running through this tune and kind of playing around with the others as my fellow note-trackers were doing their work, you know what? It is not the normal band that I would choose to listen to, but I actually had a blast playing all of these songs.
Well,
it is
great.
Not my normal, but it's fun to play.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's actually a lot of fun to play in the game.
I've been playing these a lot myself. Ghost, sort of genre nebulous.
How would you clarify them?
They're like Merciful Fate, but it's Blue Oyster Cult.
Okay.
All right.
That's a good call.
Definitely like metal aesthetics with strong pop sensibilities.
That's another way to say it.
So let's get into some Ritual.
Enjoy the lyrics.
Magic.
There it is.
All right. Nice. Thank you very much. So, I mean, it's catchy. It's a catchy tune.
It's catchy. They write very good melodies into their music. Their guitar lines are extremely melodic. Sticks in your ear and stays there. It's nice.
Right.
Yeah.
Any other any technique?
No, just have fun with it. Just have fun. Just play it. Have fun with it. Yeah.
And Elliot, who, by the way, Elliot is the riff repeater. He's the main force behind the riff repeater.
We are the riff
repeater. We are all the riff repeater, are we not? And you visited us earlier this year for the backstage pass, so this is not your first show down here. But you're a big part of our community, and we're always glad to have you.
Thank you.
Was there anything else you wanted to say about the song? Or
I mean, a lot of people get the Symphony of Destruction vibe also.
Okay.
Like a little bit of that going on. And it's a really fun bass line. If you notice, I was kind of struggling a bit at the end because there's a lot of just like movement and like return. Sometimes it's 3, sometimes it's like 10, sometimes it's like you're kind of moving. And at the end, it's really going all over the place. But it's still a pretty approachable bass line, and it's really fun. It's especially...
Well, thank you very much for visiting us while you were south of the border. And coming up right now, hopefully, if nothing has gone horribly wrong, UB Jurassic, a.k.a. Brian, will be in chat, and he's going to do a giveaway for an Ernie Ball prize pack. So let's take a look at that. See you soon. And we return once more to the land of the living. I have a nice spooky echo in my voice. I don't know if that's intentional, but it works. The effect is good. Right now, we're doing a giveaway for an Ernie Ball prize pack. This is going to be one of two that we're going to give away this stream. One right now, one at the end of this evening. We're going to give away 10 guitar strings. 6 guitar, 4 bass, for a total of 10 strings. That's a pretty good deal. We're going to give away a dozen Ernie Ball picks, 3 Rocksmith pink Skullboy picks, 1 black guitar strap, a pack of Wonder Wipes, a variety pack for your strings. Help them keep them fresh, keep them active, let them last a bit longer. We're going to give away an Ernie Ball peg winder that will help you whenever you put on those strings. It's a good combo deal for that. Today, we're going to come over, we're going to talk to Brian in the chat. Brian is going to tell you what to do to win one of these Ernie Ball prize packs. That is UB Jurassic. Just listen to his instructions in the chat. It's probably going to be mostly make sure you follow us and hit exclamation raffle to join. You can also hit exclamation waffle. It's fun, but it won't help you win. Either one is good, but we like winners. We like when you win. We like when people win and claim the prizes. When you claim your prize, when you talk to Brian about your prize, make sure you let him know your name, your real name, not just your screen name there, your real name, your address, and your telephone number. And the address, make sure we know your zip code, country, state, city, all the information to make sure you get the package that is sent to you. And right now, we're going to play another song from Ghost. Surprise, here I am with Jason Kokel.
Hello.
Jason Kokel, he is Note Tracker, can we say extraordinaire? Is that...
I guess.
The good good Note Tracker? Is that your official title?
Technical Note Tracker.
Technical Note Tracker.
Is my official title.
Okay. You want to get right into it?
If you'd like, I'll do whatever you say.
Yeah. We'll get into some Ghost. This is He Is.
Star-crossed lovers reaching out to the beast with many names. He's the shining in the light without whom I cannot see. And he is insurrection, he's spite, he's the force that makes. Stop.
That was fun.
Yeah, that was fun.
This is the first time we've played on the same song.
Yes, it is.
It's nice. So the intro to is there some 12-string or some harpsichord blended in there?
Yeah, there are two guitars as well. Okay. I believe there's, if I remember correctly, there's an alternate lead that does the harmony.
Okay.
Or at least rhythm does the harmony to lead. So both parts are represented. There's some texture, something playing the exact same things.
Possibly, is harpsichord the spookiest instrument, or can guitar maintain? guitar can be spooky.
I don't know. I think contrabassoon's spookier.
Contrabassoon. Yeah. Tuning is spooky, on any kind of bassoon.
Yeah.
Or double reed.
Yeah.
Honestly, it's a literal nightmare.
Mm-hmm.
I think. Yeah.
I'm scared.
I think
what's interesting about the song is, if it sounds approachable, it is. It's probably the one of the easiest in the pack, I would say.
Okay.
And, there's a lot of repetition, but the neat interplay between the guitars is, while maybe one is doing the same thing for a while, one's just changing one note
of
the chord, so that changes the harmony. I think it's a fairly approachable song. Sometimes you're just playing two notes for a pretty long time, and you know, it shows you don't need to do a whole lot,
right? Yeah, I think
to make it sound good.
The song seems to definitely be thematically. There's a very, very, very high theme to what's going on with the song. Most of their songs really have thematic strength. All right, coming up, we're going to hear some more from Ghost. Right now, we're going to take a look at a video from some more another heavier musician, a musician who plays some heavier music. And during that video, we're going to, you should listen to what Brian, a.k.a. Ubi Jurassic, says in chat. He will let you know how you can possibly win one of five of these Ghost song packs on Steam. And we'll be back with some more music, some more Ghost, right after that.
Learn a song.
Rocksmith is the fastest way to learn to play guitar. Plug in any electric guitar or bass into your PC or game console and choose from more than 700 songs. Learn to play in 60 days with Rocksmith. Available now.
Didn't you write this song? Yes. But I I forgot how to play it on guitar. Is that normal?
I don't know.
Maybe?
See, I don't remember any of this.
It's good, though. It's a good song. It's not bad.
Not bad. I'm now wondering if I wrote this.
And welcome back to this week's Rocksmith live stream. I'm Doug Lilly, your comm dev. I got a question. Who is this guy? Who am I? I am Doug. I am the comm dev. Dan, still around. He's still with us here at Rocksmith. He's just taking taking on some different stuff here, but he's around. He'll be with us, not tonight. He's not playing Ghost with us, but he'll be on the stream probably fairly often, maybe the other week. Can't say for him. Can't promise anything on his behalf. And we had another question in the chat, how our Halloween was. Mine was good. I watched a movie and went to bed because I'm old, and that's what I do now. I go to bed around midnight. It's that's scary. I was a night owl. Now I'm just an owl flying through the wilderness, trying to find my way, find a branch to land upon. Who? Thank you. So, if anybody else has any questions, please ask them in the chat, and Ubi Jurassic will let me know what you're asking there, and hopefully we can get to those and give you some, you know, a little bit behind the scenes look or just some further explanation on what we're talking about. Today, though, we're talking about Ghost. Once again, four songs from Ghost this week. We've got Ritual and He Is, which you've, if you've been here from the beginning, you've seen us play once earlier this week with Ritual, including Elliot, who's lovely to see. And just now, we performed He Is. Coming up right now, we're going to have Year Zero in just a moment. Before that, always let us know what you're thinking about our packs, about the DLC we're putting out. You can let us know on social media. We are on Facebook at Rocksmith. We are on Twitter and Instagram at Rocksmith Game. And then our forums, always accessible. Ubi Jurassic can post a link, or Elliot can post a link to the forums in the chat. Right now, who do we have here? We have Brian Pony and Chris Wu.
Hello.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Going well.
Yeah,
going well.
Yeah.
Good. And what are we going to play today?
We're playing Year Zero.
Year Zero, and we're going to do two. No, this is not that. We're going to do Year. Sorry,
Chris, two. Wow. Okay.
We're going to do surprise. We're going to do two surprise songs. Just kidding. Brian Pody, note tracker here. Actually, yeah. Okay. Yeah, note tracker here, and Chris Wu. Brand manager, brand director.
International product manager.
Brand
director? Wow.
I'm giving you
what a promotion.
I'm promoting
there
everyone.
There you go, Chris. Congratulations. Surprise.
Let me know what position you want, and we'll get you there.
Pody, you've been promoted to note tracker?
Congratulations.
Yeah.
Like, shake your hand.
Don't forget the question Welcome mark. It's key.
Yeah.
It is. That follows so many things in life.
What year is it?
Zero.
Year zero. I can't wait to hear it. I can, but we should probably
But you're not going to have to wait.
I'm not going to have to wait to hear it because we're going to play it right now.
It's ready to go. But are we?
I didn't get a chance to practice this again. Beelzebub. Beelzebub.
Asmodeus. Satanas. This always makes me think of that South Park.
I think of Carlos Santana.
Rectus Dominus.
Time.
uplifting track.
It is.
From an uplifting band.
It, like, musically, it's pretty,
it's,
like...
It's so driving.
Like, happy yeah. sounding?
Yeah. I mean, there's, you know...
It's
people,
like a...
People like a chant.
It's like a victory yeah. march for, like, an army, I feel like.
Oh, you know, what kind of army?
A satanic army.
Oh, fun.
Yeah, an army of darkness.
Yeah, yeah.
And I like the song because I recognize those lyrics from Diablo.
Right.
Yeah. All it's the, like, the bosses. We have fought those, right. those people.
Well, this is where I farm. Yeah. So it's a farming theme.
Yes.
Yeah.
Isn't all Satanism farming at its core?
I don't know. I'm not sure what direction you
I'm
know,
just
I don't
asking
know.
The questions, Doug.
Chat, have at it. Let us know. And you've been listening to a good bit of Ghost this week.
Yeah, just I really didn't listen to Ghost prior to us coming out with it, but I find them really, really interesting just
yeah.
because of their like their stylistic differences, how mm-hmm. they've changed their sound song to song, but a lot is album to album.
Yeah,
like how their newest album from this year sounds very different from like this song. If you look at and listen to some other tracks on your own, as well as like just the amount of effort they go to for their theatrical and the
right.
they're like mm-hmm. the Ghost musical universe that they've created,
right. and the even not even just musical, their stage shows. If you've ever seen one of their stage shows,
I haven't. Well, I've seen videos, but I haven't seen them live.
The,
but
the,
yeah,
the whole aesthetics, the costuming, and everything, very, very theatrical. It's
yeah,
yeah. And the music fits that; it suits it. One might say. And this is not. You did not note track this.
I didn't
too.
Know.
Was this
Sam?
This was Sam. Okay, yeah. Sam, who is with not he's working from home right now. So he's not with us today. Yeah, any interesting tidbits about you just played the solo. Anything fun?
I mean,
there?
Musically, it's...
I mean, the chat was happy that you got a pinch in there.
Yeah,
a
well...
You know, it was expected.
It's for the,
for the kids. Yeah.
Musically, it's like it's fairly simple.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
So
I haven't really like dug into it that
much. Focus on production and...
Yeah, like the production values of the song are very high.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
like it's an easy thing to jump in and play.
Okay. All right. Thank you both for joining us. And if you're looking for if you like Ghost and you want to see play some more stuff that might be along those lines, we've got some songs in case you missed it. We've got Monomarth, which came out last Halloween. I believe that was our Halloween song pack last year, with Twilight of the Thunder God, Death in Fire, Guardians of Asgard, The Pursuit of Vikings, and War of the Gods. Another very thematic, heavier pack. And along with them, Marilyn Manson, which I thought was similar in outlook and, again, the theatrics. This is all a very theme-heavy week. Marilyn Manson song pack had The Beautiful People, Tourniquet, and Coma White. Tainted Love was another song from Marilyn Manson, but not in that song pack. Tainted Love was with the Rockin' Covers song pack that included songs from Hailstorm, I believe, and Goldfinger, and one other that eludes me right now, Elliot Toy Machine SH, might be able to help us in the chat with the one that I'm forgetting right now. But those tracks can be found on your chosen platform. We are currently on 6 platforms. We've got Xbox 360, Xbox One, PC, Steam, PS3, and PS4. And yeah, so highly thematic music this week and in those previous packs. We are coming back right now. Oh, we're almost coming back right now. I lied. I misspoke. Coming up, we are going to hear from the final track of this Ghost song pack, which I will probably fail to pronounce. It's either Cerise, Kirka, Circe, I've heard a lot of pronunciations for this. I think one might be right. Maybe the chat can vote, let us know which pronunciation they think is right. It won't make them actually right if they have the majority, but it'll be fun, and we can decide if the majority is wrong. Happens on occasion. But right now, we're going to take a look at a couple of fine, at least one fine fellow and one nameless fellow. Hello, guys.
Hey, how's
probably.
It going?
All right. How are you doing? This is Brian Chu, way over there, and he is a note tracker with us, and
yep.
this is a nameless ghoul. I can't really tell you more because of the whole, the namelessness thing and the lack of identity, but the name of school sure does have a pretty guitar.
Mm-hmm.
What do we know about this guitar?
I think this is the guitar that Matt Heafy sent us.
Yeah.
Of Trivium.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty nice. It's, I think, got strung up with some 52. This is a 52 bottom, so
okay.
It's perfect for these drop tunings. Some nice EMG pickups. I actually have no idea what this fretboard material is, but it's kind of cool.
We can find out.
Kind of looks like the guitar, that Flying V that we got sent by
that
the
was
Death Clock guys.
Yes, the Brendan Small.
Brendan Small.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's the
similar
same material.
Vibe. Okay.
Yeah.
And you're playing is a semi-hollow?
Yeah, this is a Ivan is semi-hollow.
Okay.
That actually it has the same strings on, or like really fat strings on the bottom. So
yeah.
I was just like, yeah, I'll just bring that in because it holds the tuning pretty well.
Okay. Sounds good. So yeah, semi-hollow seems like an odd choice for this type. Of music.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, there's a few like really great metal guitar players that actually use semi-hollows, like Emil Ressler or what's his name? I don't know, whatever.
Somebody does it. Some people do it. People do it.
Some people do it.
It's not an unheard of choice, but yeah, unusual. It's nice to see it though. And this one's not answering any questions, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to cut that off. But you guys are playing Kirka?
Yeah. I call it circle because I can't say it
okay,
any other
cool.
way.
Well, if we can't say but it might sound pretty when we play it, when you play it. I'm not going to play it right now.
Yeah.
And away we go.
I can see through the scars inside you. I can't help but see the faithful.
Yeah, I think this song, which I'm told from UB Jurassic, a.k.a. Brian, your community manager for Rocksmith, I'm told it's Cerise.
Cerise.
Which sounds fake. Cerise. Cerise. Kirka. Cerise. Okay. Have fun with it. I don't know if the chat came to a conclusion ultimately. They were also, while they were trying to figure out how to pronounce the name of the song, they're also trying to figure out the name of the nameless ghoul, which seems like a futile sort of situation because they're nameless. They don't have a name. Everyone identity is void. So this song, you were playing the alt lead.
I was playing the alt lead.
While our nameless ghoul was playing the
main
representative lead.
Yeah, the main lead part.
And I saw some harmonies, and I saw an organ solo.
So basically the alt lead part is mostly the rhythm guitar part, like all the harmonies that the rhythm guitar players play,
yeah,
with the kind of synthy keyboard solo.
Okay.
After the guitar solo, we just figured we'd arrange it that way, so it'd be fun to play like this.
With the back and forth.
Yeah, yeah. Instead of having the alt lead like feature basically all the lead parts and the keyboard solo,
right?
Because that's just kind of redundant. Playing with someone else.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, this song, I think this was a song, at least in the US, that sort of got the band their sort of name,
yeah,
out there, because this is the first one that I heard on the radio.
I think this was their most requested tune that for Rocksmith, I guess.
Could be.
Yeah.
I'm not sure about
their most popular tune. Yeah. This tune is awesome. Like the riffs are just so great, and there's a lot of like, what it kind of reminded me of is like really old school, like kind of more Black Sabbath type of riffing, kind of a lot of tritones, kind of that like that kind of thing. But at the same time, they kind of mix it with like really theatrical, very melodic, epic choruses. That's like really cool. And I don't know.
These
really
quiet
awesome
moments to sort of.
Yeah, they're a very dynamic band. Like,
yeah,
they're a metal band, but they don't just play loud all the time. It's like all their songs sound completely different from each other. They have like really quiet tunes and then like just more, I don't know, like a good mix like this one. This one has everything.
Yeah. Yeah. Cool. And the name of the school is probably a hut in there.
I mean, it's already pretty hot just without.
It seems. This guy, am I right?
I mean, he's probably used to it, you know, like from
from all those times.
Those really being in the really hot places.
Right, the hot places. Where might that be? I wonder. All right,
the
good chat.
I don't know. Name that was cool. That was pretty awkward. I'm gonna
get used to that.
Now. We're gonna just ask me about music.
Sure.
I know about that.
Okay. Yeah. And did you have any statements about the rhythm part itself besides what was here?
Yeah.
Just continuing on with the riffs throughout the solo that was covered in the alt lead. That makes sense. Does the rhythm part?
The rhythm part's just basically riffs the whole time underneath the soloist.
Okay.
So you could also play that underneath and it makes sense. I mean, it's just the alt lead, the keyboard solo was just pretty ripping. And so and it sounds like a guitar, like kind of that super distorted-esque guitar patch, whatever he was using.
All right. Yeah. Well, thank you very much. And right now, we're going to take a look at our second and final for this evening, Ernie Ball prize pack. We've got two sets of strings, one six-string set for guitar, one four-string set for bass, 12 Ernie Ball picks, three special and running ever lower picks, pink Skullboy picks from us here at Rocksmith. We've got a black strap for you and a package of Wonder Wipes. And an Ernie Ball string winder, peg winder, to help you out when you are changing strings. Get in there, get out really fast. If you have, we mentioned songs that were requested for this. If there was another song, ghost or otherwise, that you wanted to hear, make sure to let us know at bit.ly/RSREQ. That's bit.ly/RSREQ. And as always, let us know on our social media. What you think about what we're coming out with. Let us know how you feel about the packs this week. Again, Ghost, four songs from Ghost. Let us know on Facebook. That's Rocksmith on Facebook or Twitter, Rocksmith Game. Instagram, also Rocksmith Game. Next week, we're going to have another song pack for you. Can't tell you yet who it's from, but there will be for whoever shows up in the forums tomorrow, the official Rocksmith forums, there will be a clue of sorts. Well, it's a clue. It's a puzzle. I've already seen it from our friend Rolling Stone 222, who has crafted this puzzle to let you know at least one of the songs in next week's song pack. That is going to be managed, sort of clue-minded, by John, our CR over in the UK, Ubisoraxia. He's going to let you know when you get it right. You probably know when you get it right, though. Usually that's how these things work out. You can join us next week for another Rocksmith live stream. And thank you very much for hanging out with us. We'll see you then. Bye. I can feel the thunder. I can see through.